An avalanche of golden Iowa corn about to be distilled into ethanol fuel to power American cars.
This is what it's all about.
Corn farmer and ethanol entrepreneur Bill Kauser runs this brand new $99 million ethanol plant that rises gleaming from the frozen prairie near the town of Nevada. For Kauser and thousands of American growers, President George Bush's call for a vast sevenfold increase in production of alternative fuels is good news.
He challenged the American farmer to an aggressive goal. And any time you've ever challenged the American farmer to come up with a solution, they've always exceeded beyond what they've had to do.
Just down the road from the ethanol plant, evidence of America's insatiable lust for oil. A nonstop parade of gas-guzzling pickup trucks and SUVs. Because of higher oil prices, sales of these big road hogs have declined by nearly 3% since last year. But there are still millions of them on the road, and many drivers aren't about to change their habits.
I mean, you can't carry quite, you know, anything in a small compact as compared to, you know, a big SUV or a truck.
The U.S. consumes about half the world's oil production and one quarter of its gasoline. So even the heartland's abundant corn cannot meet Bush's challenge of slashing U.S. gasoline consumption by 20% over 10 years. That's why scientists here at Iowa State University are studying ways to turn even more humble materials into fuel. Dr. Robert Brown is the lead scientist for this biofuels program.
We've also done switchgrass, which is a native prairie grass that grows in this part of the country, wood chips. We put in chicken litter, which is left over in the chicken house at the end of the laying season. And we've also put a bull manure, to put it politely, through this unit and produced a gas that could be converted into a gasoline-like compound.
Bull manure.
Bull manure.
Someday, this bio-oil made from plant fibers could replace millions of gallons of gasoline being used in American vehicles. The technology is here today and it works, but it's far from being economically feasible. And experts say conservation should play a major role in reducing dependence on oil.
So I think those are decisions individuals need to start making. And part of that is, what is their vision for the U.S. in the future? Do they want to see reduced reliance on imported petroleum? Do they want to see reduced greenhouse gas emissions?
But those decisions would require Americans to terminate their long, passionate love affair with big cars, a point even Bush dared not mention in his call for freedom from foreign oil. Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera, Nevada, Iowa.